Any kind of membrane off of the flesh side and any kind of epidermis off of the hair side, it's time to go ahead and brain the hide. What this part of the process does is it actually adds an oil to the fiber of the leather. And the point is to keep stretching apart the different fibers in different directions, and it gets the oil within all of those fibers and keeps them stretched out, and that's what actually softens your hide. In order to do this stage, you're going to need some kind of a kettle to cook in. Although you don't need it, I use a blender. Of course, you'll need your dried hide. And then also, you'll need brains. These are frozen brains from a butcher shop. In some areas, you can order them from a grocery store. But the bottom line is, for each hide, you'll need at least a pound to a pound and a half of brains. Let's go ahead and get started. The purpose of using brains in brain tanning is that the brains actually add an oil to the fiber of the leather, which helps soften it. And as you work it out, it'll stretch those fibers and coat them with the oil. And then the last step in the process is to smoke it, which seals the oil into the fiber and helps make it more water resistant, you could say, so that it'll dry soft once it's been wet. People use different things besides brains. I've heard of egg whites being used well. Some people have used palm olive, which doesn't make much sense to me since that should actually cut oil, but I've heard of it being used. I've also heard of organ meats being used, like the liver, but I've never tried it actually myself. Brains, though, are the traditional oil to use, and although it may be a little bit disgusting, you'll get used to it soon enough. You used to be able to buy in the Midwest entire cases of pork brains, which were relatively easy to get. Since I've moved to the Southwest, it's a little bit harder, but you should be able to contact a butcher and get brains in sheep brains, cow brains, pig brains, one thing or another, any brain will work. In general, I use about a pound to a pound and a half of brains for every deer hide that I use. The rule of thumb is that every animal has enough brains to tan its own hide. But this is my container of beef brains. And what we're going to do is go ahead and blend these. At times, I've used just my hands to mash these things up, and you get used to it after a certain amount of time. Blenders tend to work better. They're a little bit less messy on your hands. Let's go ahead and blend it. What this will do is as it chops it up, it'll make it easier for the oil to come out of the brain. Here's our brain. Or at least one of them in this bucket. And we're going to go ahead and put it in the blender. Some more. Add a little bit of water to it. Make sure the top's on securely and start blending it. I'll do a close up and you can see how well it's getting chopped up. Here's our blender full of brains, which is totally liquefied. And now that it's chopped up this well, we're going to go ahead and pour it in the kettle and cook it. The container of brains that I showed you earlier, I will wind up using the entire container on this because, frankly, you cannot overbrain a hide. With one hide, this would probably be enough. I'm using the whole container, and I'll wind up doing two hides in it. In fact, this even itself may be enough for two hides. You'd be safe for one. I'm going to go ahead and cook up enough for two. Here's our second blender full of brains. Go ahead and pour it into a large pot. And then we're going to add some water. Easiest thing, of course, is to add water as you're rinsing out your blender. We're going to fill it nearly all the way up to the top and then start cooking them. Here's the rest of our brains and mixed with water. And you can see that pink color. We're going to wind up cooking these until it turns a gray. I'd keep it on a low heat. You want to make sure that it doesn't boil over because you'll have a mess on your hands, which can be cleaned up. But basically, you just want them to turn to a gray. Some people say you don't want it to boil at all. I like to boil it a little bit. But that said, I do have a tendency that virtually every time that I do this, as I cook them, I'm not paying attention, and even on a low heat, they'll for some reason boil over. Not much, but they will. So anyway, we're going to start cooking this. Keep it at a low heat. Should be done in perhaps about an hour. Keep a fairly close eye on it. You may want to stir it occasionally. Just want the things to turn gray. Don't want it to boil over on your stove. Our brains have been on the stove on a medium heat for about 15 minutes. And, as predicted, I let them boil over, as you can see if you look down here at the bottom of the stove. You can also see, though, that they've turned gray. And I'm going to go ahead and keep them on here on a low heat for about 15 more minutes. Make sure that they're totally cooked until they're gray. And the point of this is that it basically cooks the oil out of any of the brain material. We'll go ahead and leave it on here for about 15 more minutes, and then I cook them the night before so that I can let them cool overnight. You don't want to put a hide into a bunch of hot brain material. So we'll leave it on for about 15 more minutes, then let it cool overnight, and tomorrow morning we'll wind up braining our hides. It's a lot simpler to put your hides into the braining solution if they've been softened up a little bit. The night before I go ahead and brain them, I soak them in rainwater overnight. Here's my rain barrel.